If you want your ads to look like this or like this and really stand out from the competition so that you get those clicks and sales for your products, then you have come to the right place. Because I'm going to reach out and grab your hand and guide you step by step as you watch behind my shoulder in creating your own Google Ads shopping campaign. I do suggest that you stay through to the very end of the video because every single thing I mention here is very, very important to set up your shopping campaign correctly, so you don't want to miss a beat. Are you ready? Let's get straight into it. The first thing you guys want to do is head over to ads.google.com and either sign into your account if you have a Google Ads account, or click on Start Now and create your Google Ads account. It's very easy to do, just follow some steps and you should see a page that will look like this. This will be your main Google Ads interface. Now, just so you know, every Google Ads interface might look a little different, and it's not because yours is outdated or you have the new version. It's because Google is constantly split testing different interfaces for different people. So if yours looks a little bit different, don't freak out, don't worry. Everything is gonna be the same, but for example, instead of having tools and settings on the top, you might see it on the left, okay? So the main key things that you're looking for will be the same. They might be in a different location. So that said, your page would look something like this. Before we create a shopping campaign, we do have to actually create a merchant center account with Google Ads. So to do that, we're gonna click on Tools and Settings here. Again, yours might be on the left side, on the right, whatever. And we're gonna click on Google Merchant Center. And you might see a page like this. You might also see a page that will say something like, oh, there's been an error. You don't have a Merchant Center account, so either sign in or sign up. So if you have an account, great, just sign in. If you don't, we're just gonna click on sign up for free and we're gonna follow the steps to create our own merchant account. So in our case, do you sell products online? Yes. Our store's website, we're gonna enter it with the HTTPS, say www.mamam.com. Do you have a brick and mortar store? No, we don't. We're gonna click on continue. And here just tells us some information about the Google Merchant Center. We're gonna continue to the Merchant Center. We're gonna enter the business name. In this case, let's say Iman Mehta. We're gonna set Canada as the country. And I don't want any tips, so I'm gonna leave those blank. We're gonna continue to Merchant Center. And congratulations, you have set up your Merchant Center account. So we will follow the steps here. Google will make it very nice and easy for us in an orderly fashion. We're just gonna follow through step by step and add our product. So the first thing here we have to do is to add our business address. So we're gonna click on add. I'm gonna quickly add an address here and then we'll go to the next part. Once you add your business address, you'll see a little check mark as for any other part here that we complete. And the next thing we're gonna do is verify the phone number. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna click verify. I'm gonna enter my phone number here. I'm gonna verify it and I will click continue. So once you verify your phone number, there's just one more thing you have to do, and that's confirm that your website actually belongs to you. So we're gonna click on confirm. I love the change here because now if you have an email, a business email, you can just check your email. Very simple to do, whereas before you had to go in and actually add code on your site and all that stuff. So what you will see an option here, I guess mine is already verified with this account. You will see four different options here. One is adding a code to your site. One is verifying it via a third party like Shopify and adding a code there. And another option you'll see is sending an email to your business email. So that's the option that I selected here for this example when I created my own merchant campaign. I got the email on my professional email. I checked the code and I added the code here and it automatically verified my site. So very, very simple. And then once you do that, you should see the little green check mark there as well. So one more thing we're gonna do before we add the products is add the details on how we're gonna ship our products to the different locations. So we're gonna click on add here. We're gonna choose our countries. Be careful with the countries that you select because you will need certain codes or certain tax IDs or things like that depending on the country where you're promoting. So when I was testing the different locations, I added South Korea and they made me add a South Korean business number before I was able to promote there. So if you don't have that, obviously you can't promote there, right? So for the purpose of this video, we're gonna say Canada here. So we'll click continue. And we're gonna add information, shipping information for this country. So if we have some discounts or free shipping or so on and so forth, we're gonna select all products for now since we don't have anything. And then here you're gonna change your cutoff time, your handling time, your transit time. You can see more about what they need over here. We're gonna leave it as is. We'll click on continue just to move on with the video. And then you can say, hey, free shipping completely for anybody in Canada. You can say paid shipping, so a certain paid rate, or depending on a certain price, or depending on a certain weight, or you can say free shipping over a certain amount. So you can do that here. We're gonna leave it at free shipping, quite simple. We're gonna click save. And there you go, shipping information has been added. We're gonna click done here, and our shipping has been added here, okay? If you want to change your countries, if you want to add or remove certain countries, you can do so. If you click on business info, you click on countries here, you can add countries or you can remove countries. So here we can't delete it. We need at least two countries. Once you have more countries, you'll see a little trash can icon that you can just click on and delete. And you can edit and change your shipping information over here. If you click on shipping and returns, you can do so here, and we should see the one for Canada that we did here. So that out of the way, let's go back into our overview. So the last thing we have to do is actually add the products, the meat and bones of this whole video, right? So we can click on done over here, or we can click on products right over here. Either one is fine. And we have three different ways to add products to our site, to our merchant center. So we're gonna click on add products over here. And the first option here is add products from your file. So if you already have an existing file, maybe you imported from another website where you already have your products, you could do so here. So let me quickly show you what that will look like. So you can either enter the product file URL, or you can upload file from a computer. And you can download a sample file here to see what the file will look like, so you can follow the template. But most templates are usually the same, follow the same suit. So if you have that, you can download it here. Very simple. I'm gonna go the harder route because this is too easy. If you already have it, you just upload it. So before I go into the second option here, let me show you the add products one by one, because this is super easy as well. You're gonna click here, click on continue, and you're just gonna literally add the product. So you're gonna add the product page on the online store. You're gonna add the title, the brand, the description. You're gonna drag images here, add all the price information, add SKU information, language, so on and so forth. Very simple to do, but if you have many, many products that you wanna add in bulk, this might not be the fastest option. So I'm gonna show you how you can do it much faster, and that is gonna be with this Google Sheets template. So we're gonna click here, we're gonna click on continue, and it's gonna say open a spreadsheet to fill in your details. So we're just gonna click on open spreadsheet. It's gonna ask us to choose an account here. We're gonna choose our ivanmana.com account, and here we're just gonna simply add our products. By the way, this here says delete rows 2 to 8. It's actually delete rows 2 to 5, so a little error there. So Google's gonna open this Google Merchant Center feed, and what we're gonna do is just fill in the blanks over here, okay? So as you can see, it's a little bit easier to do in bulk if you do it this way. So we're gonna start entering all our information here, starting from row 6. So this is gonna be the ID, the SKU, the product ID number, the title, the description. So you see here, this is what you need. And then here are some examples that you can draw from, okay? And then you're just gonna fill in the blanks. So we're gonna come in here, we're gonna say our IDs, for example, this for our product, since I don't actually have one. For the title, we're gonna say affiliate marketing guide. For the description, we can say this affiliate marketing guide will help you understand more about affiliate marketing and how you can start money online. The maximum is 200 characters. The maximum for the title is 150. So make sure you stick to those. You can either double click this and it's going to kind of expand it so you see everything. Or what you could also do is, if you don't want that, you can select the box, click on format over here, click on wrapping, and click on, I believe it's wrap. And that way you'll just see everything here. So a little bit easier for you to see. Now, something important for you guys to keep in mind is that with these Google Ads shopping campaigns, you aren't able to put in keywords. You aren't able to choose where you want to show your ads. Google will automatically show your ads to people based on what you have in the description and the title. What does that mean? That means you need to make sure that you have some of your important keywords and describe your product very well so that people can find it, because this is the only thing that Google will go off of when showing your products to people. So if you have affiliate marketing guide here, that could be a potential keyword that somebody would be typing in that Google would be showing your ads to, right? So we're gonna continue over here, availability, it's in stock. We're gonna add a link to our product. So it's https www.ivanmana.com. Make sure you, when you put in your site, it's with the HTTPS, all right? Not just HTTP or without it, because then Google won't fetch that site. Over here for the image link, we do need an image link that ends in one of these, right? Like JPG, PNG. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use a image hosting provider like IMGBB, and we're gonna upload our image here. We're gonna copy the link to that image, and that way it'll end in JPG or PNG. So what I'm gonna do is just upload my image here real quick. And here we have the image of my guide. We're gonna click on upload, and then IMG is gonna spit out a link, right? So this link. However, you can't use this link. Google is not gonna identify it. So what you have to do is copy this link, have to paste it here. I know it's a tedious process, and if some of you guys know of an easier way, by all means do it. But you know, for individual products, you could just do it this way. And from here, you can go ahead and click on copy image address right here, and then you can come back in here and just paste it here. And as you can see here, it ends in PNG, right? Actually, what we can do is we can just select this whole thing, click on format, click on wrapping, click on wrap, so everything is automatically like that. So that's the product link. So if you click here, you should see the image right there, right? And that's what Google's gonna pull the data from. So the next thing you wanna do is enter a price. So let's say $13.99 CAD for Canadian. Make sure you put the currency. I do actually offer the guide for free, but if you guys want to pay, let me know in the comments below. Send me an email. I will happily sell it to you for $14 instead.
Hello, I like money.
Identification number. So this is if your product has a unique identification number, such as a GTIN or an MPN. In our case, no. So we don't have to do these here. But if you do have it, then just say yes and just fill them in, right? And then for the brand, so the brand is Ivan Mana. Now, the rest of these things here, they are optional, okay? So notice how it doesn't say required. That means they're optional. So if you want to fill them in, by all means, you can, like the color, the size, the gender, you know, if you're selling the like clothes and stuff like that. So take a look, see what they have. All of these, you could fill in with more details. We don't have any of that. We just filled in the important stuff, so we're gonna leave it as is. Now, sometimes Google has a hard time fetching the data. So what I do sometimes is I click on share here and I click on anyone with the link and then I click on save, right? And that usually speeds up the process at which Google fetches my data. So that is it for the Google Sheet. So we're gonna come back in here. We're gonna say add products from spreadsheet, and now Google is gonna communicate with this sheet here and it's gonna automatically add the products. So it's adding the products. We can click on go to products to see what's going on. And it's saying updating your products. So while it's loading, what we can do is we can integrate our Merchant Center account with our Google Ads account. So to do that, we're gonna click on add campaigns over here and we can close out of this tab here just to keep things nice. We're gonna click on get started and here it's telling us to link to Google Ads. So it's making it very easy for us. So we're just gonna click on link over here and you can choose from your Google Ads account. If your Google Ads account isn't listed here, you can click on link to an account that you don't manage. So in my case, even though this is an account that I manage, for some reason it doesn't show up. So I'm just gonna manually enter my ID here. If you have a personal Google Ads account, then your account ID should be over here in the top right. If you have a manager account like I do, then your account number should be here in the top left. So I'm just gonna enter that number. Now, once you do that, you're gonna click on send link request. You're gonna send link request again. And now you should see the invitation in your Google Ads account. So we're gonna go back to Google Ads. We're gonna click on tools and settings, click on linked accounts over here. And we should see this invitation coming from our merchant center. So we're gonna click on manage and link. We're gonna click on received. Gonna click on review and we're gonna approve. So you can take a look, read through it if you like. Make sure the account number is the same. So 8212 should be the same number over here, 8212. Yeah, maybe you wanna double check, make sure the number's correct so some randoms aren't sending you these invitations. And that is it. Okay, so we have successfully linked our accounts. So now we will be able to actually create a campaign. By the way, let's refresh this, make sure it's successfully linked. We should see a little green check mark saying that it's been linked successfully. Don't worry about the other stuff. You can do those in Google Ads. So let's go back into products. Let's see, make sure everything is good.
Something went wrong.
Oh, okay. So important stuff. We forgot to delete rows 2 to 4. Okay. So something that I mentioned and forgot to do. So very important. So we're going to click here. We're going to delete rows 2 to 4. Sorry, this one as well. So that you should only see this, like the titles, right, of the columns, and then what you actually wrote it, okay? So once you do that, you can click on view data sources over here, and you should see the Google Docs here. You can click on update right over here. It should start fetching the data here as well. And if you want to edit it, let's suppose you don't have that open, you can go ahead and edit it right here. So you can click on the Google Docs and just make sure that looks good. So we're gonna click update here again. We're just gonna make sure that it's gonna fetch the data now. Let's close out of that. So right now it says update in progress. These two should not be there, right? They're not approved because they're not real products. So it's 9:58, it's 10:02 right now. So we'll just give it a second to make sure that it's updated to the latest version. And then we're gonna continue by adding our campaign on ads. So while Google is updating our information on the Excel sheet, what we're gonna do is start by creating a campaign. And that way, once Google updates the information, the campaign will immediately go live with those products, all right? So what we're gonna do here is click on create campaign, click on new campaign. And the same for you, by the way, keep in mind that to update the Excel sheet, it might take 10 to 15 minutes as well, okay? So don't freak out if you don't see the changes right away. So over here, we're gonna click on sales. We're gonna choose our conversion goal. If you don't have conversion goals set up yet, check out my video where I show exactly how to do it step by step. Very, very easy to do. We're gonna click on continue here and we're gonna select shopping campaign. So now it's gonna make us choose the account. That's why it was important to set up this shopping campaign right away. Make sure it matches. So this was our shopping campaign that we created. We do have products being loaded right now and updated, so we're just gonna ignore this message for now. And we're gonna select standard shopping campaign because a performance max campaign is something a little different. And I do show how to do that in a previous video, so make sure to check that out. We're gonna go with standard shopping campaign here. We're gonna click on continue. Close out of this Excel tab here. So for the campaign name, let's suppose we wanna say Yvonne Mana free guide. For the bidding option, you can choose whatever option you like. If you're just starting out and you have no conversion data, I do suggest just going with manual CPC like that. If you do have some conversion data, you can go for optimized conversions or optimized conversion value if you have many different price points and you want to focus on the one that gets you the most revenue. Then we're gonna set a budget, let's say $20. Now for the campaign priority, as I was saying earlier, you aren't able to add keywords, right? That means for different campaigns, if you have different campaigns with similar products, they might show to the same audience. So all of your campaigns might show to people if they type in a certain search term. So to avoid that problem from happening, what you could do is prioritize your campaign. So you could say, hey, if somebody types in a certain keyword that triggers multiple campaigns, I want this campaign to show up. This is the most important campaign. Or another campaign that's very low priority, I really don't want it to show up until my other two or three campaigns have been shown. So this is where you would set this priority. We only have one campaign, doesn't matter. We're gonna leave it at low, but that's what this is. Now for networks, we're gonna deselect this. So we only show our ads on Google, but if you want to get a little adventurous, you can select this and you can show your ads on Google partners as well. You would enter your location because we're shipping only to Canada. We're gonna leave it to Canada, but you can click on add another location and you can choose your locations over here. You also have some location options. You can go in and play around with these. I do suggest selecting this option here and not this one so that you show your ads to people who are actually physically in the location they select. You can choose the start and end date over here. You can enter an ad group name. So if you have many different products, you can do so here. So this one, for example, is the affiliate guide ad group. For the bid, let's say 25 cents. And we're gonna click on create campaign. Oops, select location. Let's click Canada here again. Let's click on create campaign. And so there you go, congratulations, you have successfully created your campaign. And I'm gonna wait for the products to actually get approved to show you what it will look like. Then you're gonna click on keywords over here and you can add negative keywords based on the search term. So you can see what people are typing in and then you can go in and you can actually add the negative keywords. You can change your location here, change the ads, all that stuff. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna give it some time for the products to get approved and then I'm gonna show you what that's gonna look like here in your Google Ads and your Merchant Center. So here, as you can see here, it has approved, and for all your products, you're gonna see either a green check mark or a little red X that's gonna say not approved, and it will give you the reasons. When you go to needs attention, it's gonna tell you the reasons for what you have to fix and why your product wasn't approved so you can fix it. And then inside of your account, if you click on product groups, you will be able to select what groups you want for each specific ad group. So if you click on over here, the little plus sign, right now I'm promoting all the products, but you can choose which ones and you can sort by all these different options. So category, brand, item ID. So if you go to category, for example, let's suppose you want to make an ad group for a specific category. So you would just choose from the category right here. You can go by condition and you can say, okay, I only want to have an ad group to promote new products, another ad group for used products, so on and so forth. This is where you would be able to do it, all right? And once you do that, yeah, you'll see your products here. Let me go back to the, where's the shopping campaign here? So you have the product groups where you choose the products, and then over here, you're gonna see the data for the product. So here it says ready to serve. You're gonna see the clicks, impressions, CTR for each of the specific products. And that is how you create a Google Ads shopping campaign. If you guys found value in this video, I do suggest to check out my website at yvonnemana.com. where I offer a free affiliate marketing guide to help you get started with affiliate marketing, as well as offer training courses to help you master these paid ad networks, as well as learn how to make money online with the Affiliate Marketing Mastery course. That said, thank you guys for watching. I will see you in the next video.